Hello everyone, my name is Myron McCartney and welcome to Lex Justice Chambers. The Bahamas offers a wide variety of methods used in the facilitation of business startups, perhaps the most popular being the registration of sole proprietorships under the parameters of the Business License Act of 2010. Sole proprietorships are also known as sole traders, which is recognized as a type of business that is owned and operated by one person and that there is no legal distinction between that individual and the business itself. Under this type of enterprise, the proprietor is the owner of all assets and is the beneficiary of all profits earned by the business, while in turn having full responsibility for all debts, taxes, losses, and other liabilities endured by the enterprise. It is important to note that sole proprietorships here in the Bahamas do not embody a legal entity that benefits from the legal liability protections under Bahamian law. So for example, if the sole proprietorship was subject to legal action, the assets involved in the business activities, as well as the assets owned personally by the sole proprietor, will all be rendered vulnerable if the business was found liable in the action. Now, sole proprietorships are registered with the Department of Inland Revenue, where the proprietor's full legal name will be used as the sole proprietorship's business name. The proprietor will also have the option of registering a trading as name for the enterprise. A trading as name is the name that will be used by the enterprise to identify itself to the public, which will often be used as the company's name in advertising or marketing. So for example, John Doe, a local fashion designer here in the Bahamas, wishes to register a sole proprietorship in order to facilitate the sale of his new men's clothing line, which he has named JD Fashions. On his business license, the license will bear the name John Doe, while trading as JD Fashions. With his new business license in hand, John Doe can now open up a business account at a local bank where he can accept payments under the name JD Fashions. He could also use the name to rent retail space where he can sell his clothing physically on the island, as well as advertise in the newspapers and local magazines and so forth. In considering the amount of time and effort it takes to register a sole proprietorship and to obtain its business license, the Bahamas Department of Inland Revenue has recently implemented its provisional license scheme. This allows for an applicant to obtain a provisional license, which lasts for a period of 90 days, in order to complete tasks which are deemed critical to the business enterprise. This may include obtaining a bank account for the business at a local bank, or entering into a lease agreement in order to rent retail space for the business itself. Examples of low-risk businesses include housekeeping services, couriers, retailers of general goods, consultants, and small contractors. So if you have any further questions on this topic, please feel free to visit our website at www.lawyerlex.com.